Hello there. I'm AE86, and I aspire to be a street race car. I can move around, recognize images, connect to other devices, and many more. I am built by the wonderful people from MDP Group 20. Let's see what they have to say about me.
Android enables communication between us and the robot. Using the Bluetooth library, we pair Android with RPi Bluetooth. This enables connection between RPi and Android, so the messages as seen in the video can be sent by and to Android tablet. The coordinates of the obstacle can be keyed in simply by dragging the obstacle onto the grid. The direction of the obstacle can be changed by tapping on obstacles. Android can then send the coordinates of the obstacle to the RPi as a string. After the algorithms calculate the path, RPi will send Android the same command it sends to the STM robot. Android will then animate the movement on the grid to simulate the real-time movement of the robot. Upon receiving the image ID of the recognized image, Android will update the correct ID on the tablet.
The direction of motion is controlled using our servo motor. We utilize both sensors, ultrasonic placed at the front and IR sensors placed at the side, to avoid objects while moving. We have four sets of movements, forward, reverse and left-right turns. There are two types of turns implemented, arc turn, which is faster but with a larger turning radius, and spot turn, which is small turning radius but significantly slower due to multiple adjustments.
RPi is the brains and the eyes of the robot. It is used to connect all the components together and take pictures using its camera for image recognition. We use socket programming to allow RPi to communicate with our tablet and PC, and serial to connect with our STM32. The RPi has a low-powered 64-bit quad-core A53 processor with a single gigabyte of RAM. To increase our computational speed, we do most of the heavy processing, such as image recognition and algorithm computation off-site on a more powerful gaming laptop. Our image recognition uses state-of-the-art YOLO V5 library to train our dataset of more than 2,000 images and perform detections quickly.
For the algorithm component, we opted towards brute forcing all possible paths before deciding on the least cost path based on the A-star algorithm. The algorithm accounts for the heuristics and greedy measurements of each path, using the Manhattan distance between the start and goal node for heuristics, while assigning costs to both straight line and arc turn movements for greedy measurements. We place heavier penalties on arc turns, which resulted in straight line movements having lower costs and being preferred overall. The biggest issue we faced was representing the number of grids displaced in an arc turn movement. To solve this, we settled on a 3x coordinate and 1y coordinate displacement for the robot.
Oh whoa, isn't that interesting? And with all their efforts combined, I managed to achieve good results during my task assessments. Throughout their MDP journey, my creators have demonstrated wit and resilience. They have poured their heart and soul out into designing me to the best of their abilities. But more importantly, they have developed a close bond with one another. And that is truly special.